Why do you always wear black?
I'm in mourning for my life. I'm unhappy.
Why? I don't get it. You're healthy, your father, though not rich, is comfortably off. My life is much more difficult than yours. I earn 23 rubles a month, with pension contributions taken out of it, and I still don't wear mourning.
It's not a question of money. A pauper can be happy.
In theory, yes, but the reality is there's myself, my mother, my two sisters, and little brother. My total salary is 23 rubles. We have to eat and drink, don't we? And buy tea and sugar and tobacco. So try and manage on that.
The play will begin soon.
Yes. Nina is acting and Konstantin has written the play. They're in love with each other and today their souls will be united to give the same dramatic effect. But my soul and yours have no common points of contact. I love you, and because of that longing, I can't sit still at home. Every day I walk 6 versts here and 6 versts back, and I just get indifference from you. I get it. I'm poor, I have a large family. How can you want to marry a man that has nothing to eat?
Nonsense. I'm grateful for your love, but I can't feel the same way. That's all. Help yourself. It's heavy. There'll be a storm tonight. You're always philosophizing and talking of money. And in your eyes, there's no greater misfortune than poverty. But in mine, it's 1,000 times easier to go in rags and live by begging than to. But you won't understand that.
The country isn't really for me, old man. Of course, I'll never truly get accustomed to life here. Last night, I went to bed at 10, and this morning I woke at 9, feeling as if my brain had sort of stuck to my skull from a long sleep, and so on and so on. And then, today, after lunch, without meaning to, I again went to sleep, and now I feel quite shattered, as if I'd had a nightmare. Well, at the end of the day.
Yes, you should live in the city. My friend, when it starts, you'll be cold, but you shouldn't be here now. Go away, please.
Masha, would you be kind enough to tell your papa to let the dog off its chain, or else it will bark? My sister did not sleep again last night.
Ask him to yourself. I won't. You don't ask me to. Let's go.
You'll send to someone to tell us when the play begins.
Yeah, that means that dog will howl again all night. It's funny. I never lived in the country as I always wanted to. I used to take 3 weeks leave and come out here to relax and so on and so on, but they'd get at you with all sorts of nonsense that you'd want out by the very first day. I used to leave here with pleasure. But now I'm retired, and at the end of the day, I have nowhere to put myself. Whether you want to or not, you've got to live according to it.
Konstantin, we're going for a swim.
Right. Only be in your places in 10 minutes. It'll start soon.
Yes, sir.
Here's a stage for you. You have the wings and the curtain, and then nothing. Empty space. You look straight out over the lake and the horizon. We'll raise the curtain at 8:30 on the dot when the moon rises.
That's splendid.
If Nina is late, then, of course, the whole effect will be ruined. Her father and stepmother guard her like she's in a prison. Your hair appeared to ruffle. Shouldn't you have a haircut?
The curse of my life. Even when I was young, I looked like a drunk, and so on and so on. Women never loved me. No. Tell me, why is your mother in such a bad mood?
Why? She's bored. She's jealous. She's against me now and against the performance because Nina will be having success on this little stage rather than herself. She doesn't know my play, but she hates it already. A psychological curiosity, my mother. Unquestionably talented. Clever. Capable of crying over a book. She'll declaim all of Nekrasov for you from memory, but you just try to praise Zeus in front of her. One must only have praise for her. One must write about her and go into ecstasies about her fantastic performance in La Dame or Camellia or Life is Hell. But since there are none of those drugs out here in the country, she gets bored and nasty. We're all her enemies. We're all to blame.
So you've imagined that your mother doesn't like your play, and now you're getting all upset about it, and so on and so on. Calm down, your mother worships you.
She loves me. She loves me not. She loves me. She loves me not. She loves me. She loves me not. You see, my mother doesn't love me. Of course not. She wants to live, to love, to wear bright dresses, and here I am, 25 years old, a constant reminder that she's no longer young. You see, when I'm not there, she's only 32, but when I am, she's 43, and she hates me for it. Besides, she knows I don't accept the theatre. She loves the theatre. She thinks she's serving humanity and the sacred cause of art. Well, in my opinion, the theatre of today is nothing more than hidebound and conventional. When in a room with three walls and artificial light, these great geniuses, these priests of holy art, ask how to eat, drink, walk about, and wear our jackets. When in these banal scenes and phrases, they try to dish out a moral. Some little moral that is so easily grasped and suitable for domestic use. When in 1,000 variations I am served the same thing over and over again. And then I flee. As Maupassant fled the Eiffel Tower, which made his brains reel with vulgarity.
We can't do without the theatre.
Well, we need new forms, that's what we need. And if there are none, I feel we'd be better off having nothing at all. I love my mother. I love her dearly, but it's a tomfool life she leads. With that novelist always on her elbow, and her name forever in the papers, it disgusts me. Sometimes it's the egoism of the ordinary man that really speaks to me. I'm sorry that my mother is a famous actress, and I feel if she'd been an ordinary woman, then I would have been happier. Uncle, what could be sadder and sillier than my situation at home is with her? Her drawing room is always filled with actors and writers and other celebrities, and amongst them the only nobody is myself. But who am I? But who am I? I left university in first year in situations which they said were beyond the editor's control. I have no talent, not a kopeck to my name. On my passport it says, I'm a petty bourgeois from Kiev. My father was a petty bourgeois from Kiev, but he too was a famous actor. So when all those actors and writers and other celebrities used to give me their gracious attention, I felt that they were only measuring my nothingness. I read their thoughts and had agonies of humiliation.
By the way, tell me, please, what sort of a man this writer is? You can't make him out. He never speaks.
He's a simple man. Intelligent. A little, you know, melancholy. He's a long way short of 40, but he's already famous and well-fed. What more can I tell you? His stories are pleasant. But after Tolstoy and Zola, you wouldn't want to read Trigorin.
Ah, the literary world. How I love it, old boy. I used to want two things, passionately. I wanted to marry, and I wanted to become a writer. Well, I didn't succeed in either aim. To be even a second-class writer at the end of the day.
I hear footsteps. Even the sound of her footsteps are beautiful. I'm madly happy. My enchantress, my dream.
Oh, I'm not late, of course I'm not late.
No.
I was worried all day. I was so frightened. I was afraid my father wouldn't let me go. But he went out just now with my stepmother. A lovely sky. The moon was beginning to rise, and I drove my horse hard. But I'm glad.
No, it looks as if your little eyes have had tears. Oh, that's no good, no, not at all.
No, you see how out of breath I am. I'm going in half an hour, you must hurry. I have to. You mustn't keep me, for God's sakes. My father doesn't know I'm here.
Yes, we should go and get everyone.
I'll go get them. This minute.
To France! Two grenadiers!
Once, I sang like that. And the deputy public prosecutor said to me, "My, what a powerful voice Your Excellency has." But then he paused for a moment and added, "Ah, but not a pleasing one."
My father and his wife won't let me come here. They say you're Bohemians. They're afraid I might become an actress. But I'm drawn here to the lake like a seagull. My heart is full of you.
We're alone.
I think someone's there.
No one.
What kind of tree is that?
An elm.
Why is it so dark?
It's evening now, everything's dark. Don't leave early, Nina, I beg you.
You mustn't beg me.
Oh, but what if I come with you? I'll stand in your garden all night and look at your window.
You mustn't, the watchman will see you. And Tozer isn't accustomed to you and he'll bark.
I love you.
Shh.
Is that you, Yakov?
It is!
Have we got the spirit? Have we got the sulfur? When the red lights appear, we need the smell of sulfur. Are you nervous?
Yes, very. Your mama. Doesn't matter, I'm not frightened of her. But Trigorin is here. I'm scared and I feel awkward acting in front of him. Famous writer. Is he young?
Yes.
Wonderful his stories are.
I wouldn't know, I haven't read them.
It's difficult to act in your play. It has no living characters.
Living characters? Life should not be shown as it is or as it ought to be, but as it appears in dreams.
Your play has no action, only speeches. And I think a play should definitely have some love interest. It's getting damp. Go back and put on your galoshes.
I'm hot.
You don't look after yourself. It's stubbornness. You're a doctor, and I'm very well Danbury is bad for you, but you want me to suffer. Yesterday, you deliberately sat out on the terrace the whole evening.
Say not that youth's destroyed.
You were so carried away talking to Arkadina that you didn't even notice the cold. Admit it. You find her attractive.
I'm 55.
Nonsense. For men, that's not old. And you really kept your looks and are still attractive to women.
So what can I do for you?
You're all ready to fall on your faces before an actress, all of you.
Afresh before the eye. If society loves actors and treats them differently from, say, shopkeepers, that is in the order of things. It's idealism.
Women have always loved you and hung on your neck. Is that idealism too?
So, there was a love that was good in women's feelings for me. They chiefly loved the first-class doctor. 10 or 15 years ago, you remember, I was the only decent obstetrician in the whole province, and I always behaved honorably.
My dearest. Stop, they're coming.
Oh, she gave amazing performance at the Palatine Fair in 73. Pure ecstasy, she was amazing, but tell me after dinner. Where is Powell, the comedian, now? He was great at Jasper's work, even better than Sadovsky. Pray, my dear lady, where is he now?
You're always asking about some has-been. How would I know?
Oh, Pascal Chabot, there was no one like him. The theatre is in decline, Arkadina. Once we saw great oaks, and now we see stumps.
There are a few brilliant talents now, that's true, but the quality of the average actor has gone up a lot.
Oh, I have to disagree with you, but it's a matter of taste. Augustibus at bene at nihil.
My dear son, when does it begin?
Oh, in a moment. Patience, please.
Oh, Hamlet, speak no more. Thou turnest to mine eyes, into my very soul. And there I see such black and green and spots as do not leave their tint.
Nay, but to live in the rank and sweat of an inseamed bed, stewed and honeying in corruption, making love over the nasty sty. Ladies and gentlemen, it is beginning. Your attention, please. O you honored ancient souls, that are born at night over this lake, let us sleep and dream of what will be in 200,000 years.
In 200,000 years, there will be nothing.
Then let us be shown that nothing.
Yes, indeed. We are sleeping.
Men, lions, eagles, and partridges. Antlered deer, geese, spiders, silent fish which live in the water, animals and organisms invisible to the eye. In short, all life has come together after completing its sad cycle. For thousands of centuries, the earth has not borne a single living being, and this poor moon lights her lantern to no purpose. In the meadow, the cranes give their waking cry no more, and in May, the cockchafers are no longer heard in the lime groves. The bodies of living beings have turned into dust, and the father of eternal matter has changed them into stones, into water, into clouds. And all their spirits have merged into one. I am that universal spirit. In me is the spirit of Alexander the Great, and Shakespeare, and Napoleon, and that of the meanest leech. In me, human consciousness has merged with animal instinct. And I remember everything, everything, everything. And in each life, I live out in myself the new.
What decadent rubbish! Mama!
I am lonely. Once in 100 years, I open my mouth to speak, and my voice sounds dolefully in this emptiness, and no one hears me! And you, pale lights, do not hear me. Towards dawn, the decaying marsh spawns you, and you roam till dawn, but without thought, without will, without tremor of life. Afraid that life might begin in you, the father of eternal matter, the devil, changes your atoms every instant, like those of the rocks and the water, and you continuously change. Only one spirit in the universe remains constant and immutable. Like a prisoner cast into an empty deep well, I do not know where I am and what awaits me. It's only revealed to me that in the unyielding, cruel fight with the devil, the principles of the forces of matter, I am destined to conquer. And thereafter, matter and spirit will blend into a beautiful harmony, and there will come the kingdom of universal will. But this will only be by when little by little, over a long sequence of millennia, the moon and bright Sirius and the earth will have turned to dust. But till then, horror! Horror! My mighty enemy, the devil, approaches. I see his fearsome crimson eyes.
I smell sulfur. Is that intentional?
Yes.
Yes, it's effective.
Ma!
I am lonely without man.
Take it off your hat. Put it back on. You'll catch a cold.
The doctor has taken off his hat to the devil. The father of internal matter.
That's it. Enough. Close the curtain.
Why are you angry?
Close the curtain. I'm sorry. I lost sight of the fact that only a select few can act and write and play. I broke the monopoly. For me,
What is the matter with him?
Irina, my dear, you mustn't insult a young man's pride like that.
What did I say to him?
You offended him.
He warned us it was a joke, and I treated his play like a joke.
Still.
Now it turns out he's written a great work. What next? He must have arranged this performance with its smell of sulfur. Not as a joke, but as a demonstration. He wanted to teach us, how to write, and what to perform. In the end, it gets boring. His constant attacks on me, his needling would try anybody. Capricious, self-obsessed boy.
He wanted to please you.
Really? However, he didn't choose some ordinary play, but made us listen to these decadent ravings. As a joke, I'm prepared to listen to raving. But here we have claims to new forms, to a new age in art. In my opinion, there are no new forms here, but simply bad behavior.
Every man writes as he wants and as he's able to.
Let him write as he wants, and as he's able to. Then let him leave me in peace.
Jove, thou art angry.
I am not Jove, but a woman. I am not angry. I'm only vexed that a young man should spend his time so tediously. I didn't want to offend him.
No one has grounds for separating spirit from matter yet. Spirit itself is combinations of atoms and matter. Yet imagine, writing a play and performing on the stage the existence of yours truly, a schoolmaster.
Fair enough. We were in talk of plays or atoms. Such a lovely evening. Do you hear, my friends, the singing? Doesn't it feel good?
It's from the far shore.
10, 15 years ago here on this lake we heard constant music and singing almost every night. There are 6 estates on the shore. I remember there was laughter, noise, shooting, and romance. The genre premiere and idol of these 6 houses was then, I present, Dr. Yves Denise Arkadievich. Even now he's enchanting, but then he was irresistible. However, my conscience is beginning to bother me. Why did I offend my poor boy? I am troubled. Kostya! Foster!
I'll go and look for you.
Oh, please, dear.
Konstantin!
Since it's clearly not going on, I can come out now.
Admiration, looking as you do, with such a wonderful voice. You mustn't sit in the country. It's a sin. You've clearly got a talent. Do you hear? You have to go on the stage.
Oh, it's my dream. But it won't ever come true.
Oh, who knows? May I introduce you to Boris Alexeyevich Trigorin?
I'm so pleased. I always read you.
Don't be embarrassed, my dear. He is a celebrity, but he has a simple soul. You see, he himself is embarrassed.
I think we can close the curtain now, or it feels odd.
Yes, Yakov, get the curtain, please.
Wasn't that a strange play?
Why, yes, I understood nothing, but I watched with such pleasure. And you act with such sincerity. And the set is lovely.
Why?
There must be a lot of fish in that lake.
Yes, there are.
I love to fish. I find there no greater pleasure than sitting on the bank and watching my float.
But I imagine after experiencing the pleasures of creativity, no other pleasures could exist anymore.
I mean,
don't talk like that, my dear. When people say nice things to him, he shrivels up.
I remember once at the opera in Moscow. The great silver hit the bottom sea, and you can imagine our amazement when the choir boy's voice rang out from the gallery, "Bravo, silver!" Even as low, you say, so low, decimal times, "Bravo, silver!" The audience rose.
An angel just passed.
And I must go. Goodbye.
Where are we going so early?
Pa is waiting for me.
Father. Well, there we are. I'm sorry to let you go.
If only you knew how hard it is for me to leave.
Someone could go with you. My lamb.
Oh, no.
Stay.
I can't be sorry.
Just for an hour and so on. Well.
I can't.
An unfortunate girl, really. You say her dead mother left all her huge estate to her husband. Down to the last kopeck. And now this girl has nothing. The father has already left everything to his second wife. It's shocking.
Yes, her papa is a real swine. One must give him full credit for that.
Let's head in too, ladies and gentlemen, or else it will be getting damp. My legs are aching.
They're barely moving. They're made of wood. Come on, you poor old thing.
Chambrier, you wouldn't be so good as to tell them to let the dog off its chain, otherwise it will bark.
I'm afraid not, sir, and I'm afraid the thieves will get into the bar, and I have Millet in there. Bravo, Silva! It was amazing. You wasn't even a professional singer.
I don't know. Perhaps I understand nothing or have gone out of my mind, but I liked the play. There's something there. There really is. When the girl spoke of loneliness, and then when the red eyes of the devil appeared, my hands shook from emotion. Fresh, simple. I want to say a lot of nice things about him.
There's no one left.
I'm here.
Marcia's looking for me all over the park. She's just intolerable.
Konstantin, I really liked your play. It was a little strange, and I didn't see the end, and still it made a strong impression. You're a gifted man and must go on. You're a nervous chap. Tears in your eyes. What do I mean?
You've taken a theme from the realm of abstract ideas. Rightly so, because a work of art absolutely needs to contain some great thought. Beauty only lies in what is serious.
How pale you are.
So you're telling me to carry on?
Yes, but only depict what is important and eternal. You know, I've lived a varied life. I've enjoyed it. I'm content. But if I ever came to feel the upsurge of spirit which artists have at the moment of creation, I would scorn my material shell and all that belongs to it, and I would be carried up from earth.
Excuse me, but where's
Nina? And another thing, a work must contain clear and defined thought. You must know the object of your writing. Otherwise, if you head down that picturesque road without a definite aim, you will lose your way and your talent will destroy
you. I'm sorry, but where's Nina?
She's gone home.
Gone? What am I to do?
Calm down, my friend.
Go inside, Konstantin. Mama's waiting for you. She's worried.
Tell her I've gone. And I beg you, don't follow me.
But my dear fellow, you mustn't. It's not right.
Thank you, Doctor.
Youth.
And there's nothing else to say. People say youth.
That's nasty. I think they're playing indoors. We must go.
Wait a moment.
What?
I want to speak with you. I want to talk. I don't love my father. My heart goes out to you. For some reason, I feel with all my soul that you are close to me. Help me, or I'll make a mockery of my life. I'll spoil it. I can't any longer.
What? Help you in what?
No one knows how unhappy I am. I love Konstantin.
You're all so highly strung. So highly strung. And what a lot of love. Oh, enchanted lake. What can I do, my child? What? What can I do?
Enough of that. Let's stand up. by side. You are 22, and I am almost twice that. Evgeny Isaevich. Which of us looks younger?
You, of course.
So, and why is that? Because I work. I feel. I'm constantly busy. But you are always sitting in one place. You don't live. And I have a rule. Don't look into the future. I never think of old age or death. What will be, will be.
And I feel as if I'd been born long, long ago. I carry my life about with me, like in this trail of a dress. And every so often I've no urge to live. It's all nonsense, of course. I must pull myself together, get rid of it all.
Tell her flowers mine.
Then I'm as correct as an Englishman. My dear, I keep myself, as they say, in training. And my clothes and my hair are always comme il faut. Would I let myself go out of the house, even just into the garden here, in a house coat, without doing my hair? Never. I have lasted because I have never been slovenly. I have never let myself go. Like some. There, like a young bird. I can play a girl of 15.
Well, I'll go on anyway. We stopped at the corn chandler and the rats.
And the rats? Read on. No, give it to me. I'll read. My turn. And the rats. Here it is. And of course, it is just as risky for fashionable folk to pamper novelists and take them to their bosoms as it is for a corn chandler to breed rats in his barns. But they love them. And so, when a woman has chosen the writer whom she wants to snare, she lays siege to him with compliments, favors, and treats. Well, maybe the French do, but we have nothing like that. Nothing so programmatic. Here, a woman, before she sets out to capture a writer, is usually head over heels in love herself. Without going very far, take me and Trigorin.
Well, are we happy today? Are we cheerful at last? We are happy, for father and stepmother have gone to Tver, and we are free now for 3 whole days.
I'm happy, and one of you now.
She's rather pretty today.
Yes, elegant, attractive, and you're a clever girl. But we mustn't praise you too much, or bring bad luck. Where's Boris Alexeyevich?
He's fishing at the bathing place.
Why doesn't he get bored?
What are you reading?
Malpassant's Saludia. Like droplets of water, the boundless praise falls at each word on the impressionable heart of the literary man. Well, it gets uninteresting and false. My heart is anxious. Tell me, what is the matter with my son? Why is he so boring and grim? He spends whole days in the lake and I hardly see him at all.
He's depressed. Please read from this play.
Do you want me to? So uninteresting.
Can he read something himself? His eyes burn and his face turns pale. He has a beautiful, melancholy voice and in the manner of a poet.
Good night.
A true shot.
Did you go to sleep?
Certainly not.
You're not having any medical treatment. That's bad, brother.
Well, I'd be glad to. But doctor here doesn't want me to have any.
Prescriptions for a 60-year-old.
Even at 60, one wants to live.
Oh, well, take some valerian drops.
I think it would be good for him to go somewhere and take the waters.
Well, he can go or not go.
So try and understand.
There's nothing to understand. Everything is clear.
But you don't want to give up smoking, at least.
Rubbish.
No, not rubbish. Alcohol and tobacco take away the personality. After a cigar or a glass of vodka, you are no longer Soren, but Soren plus someone else. Your eye dissolves and you relate to yourself like a third person. He.
Yes, well, that's all very well for you to argue. You've had a good life. But what about me? I served 28 years in the Department of Justice, and I never began to live. I left without any experience of life, and so, understandably, I very much want to live. But you are well fed. Life is easy for you. So you are inclined towards philosophy. But I want to live, so I drink sherry and smoke cigars and so on and so on. You know.
One must have a serious attitude to life, and to go for medical treatment aged 60. To believe you haven't had much pleasure in youth is, forgive me, silly.
It must be time to have lunch. My legs won't sleep.
It'll go and put down two glasses before lunch.
The poor thing has no personal happiness.
Empty words, Your Excellency.
You're arguing like a well-fed man.
What can be more boring than this nice rural tedium? It's hot. It's quiet. Everyone talks philosophy. It is good to be with you, my friends. Pleasant to listen to, but to sit in a hotel room and learn part is so much better.
Splendid. I understand you.
Well, of course it's better in town. You sit in your study. Your man lets no one in without announcing them. There sits the telephone, there are cabs on the street, and so on and so on.
Tell her flowers mine.
Hello, everyone. Oh, it's so good to see you in good health.
Hello.
Hello. So, my lady, the wife tells me you're going into town today.
Yes, that's the plan.
That's all well and good, but may I ask how you get there? The rye is coming in today and all the men are taken out. What horses will you use?
What horses? How do I know what horses?
We have the carriage horses.
The carriage horses? The carriage horses, and where will I get the harnesses? Where will I get the harnesses? Oh, this is ridiculous, beyond comprehension. My darling, I worship you. I would give you 10 years of my life, but I cannot give you the horses.
But what if I have to go? A strange business.
My lady, you do not know farming.
An old story. In that case, I am leaving for Moscow today. Get them to take the horse from me in the village, or I'll walk to the station on foot.
And in that case, I resign. Find yourself another manager.
Every summer I am like this. Every summer I am insulted. I won't set foot here again.
Arkadina, the famous actress. Is it not her every wish, even caprice, more important than your farming? Just unthinkable.
What can I do? Put yourself in my position, what can I do?
Come, we will all go to my sister. We'll beg her not to leave.
Slow down, let me take you.
Intolerable man! A tyrant!
Oh, how awful this is.
Yes, it is awful, but he won't get away with it. I will speak to him right away.
Yes.
People are boring. Really, your husband should be thrown out if you're on his ear. But it will all end with that old woman, Sorin, and his sister begging her pardon. You'll see.
He sent the carriage horses onto the fields, too. And every day there are misunderstandings like this. Oh, if only you knew how it upsets me, I'll get ill. Go to me, my dear, my beloved. Take me into your heart. Our time is passing, and if only at the end of our lives we could stop concealing and lying.
I'm 55. It's too late now to change my life.
I know you're refusing me because there are other women besides me who are close to you. You can't take them all in. I understand. Forgive me. I get on your nerves.
No, not at all.
I suffer from jealousy. You're a doctor and you can't avoid women. I understand.
Well, how is it in there?
Arkadina is crying and Peter Sorin has asthma.
Oh, well, let's go and give both of them valerian
drops. Here.
Sylvie.
Oh, what a pretty flower. Give me that. How strange to see a famous actress crying. And strange that the famous writer, the darling of the public, stories about him in all the papers, his picture for sale, translate him to foreign languages, spends all day fishing and is delighted to have caught a couple of chub. I thought famous people were proud and unapproachable, that they despised the world and that through their fame, through the glory of their name, they, as it were, took revenge on the public, valuing high birth and wealth above all else. But here they cry and fish and play cards and get angry, just like everybody else.
Are you alone?
Yes, alone.
What's that supposed to mean?
I was a brute today and killed this seagull. I lay it at your feet.
What's the matter with you?
Soon I'll kill myself like this.
I don't recognize you.
Yes. Since I stopped recognizing you, you've changed towards me. Your eyes are cold, my presence embarrasses you.
You've become irritable recently. You express yourself incomprehensibly in some kind of symbolic language. And the seagull's clearly a symbol of something, but forgive me, I don't understand.
I'm too simple to understand you.
It all started on the night of my play's stupid failure. Women don't forgive failure. I burned the lot to the very last scrap of paper. If only you knew how unhappy I am. Your coldness towards me is frightening. Incredible as if I woke up and this lake had dried up or floated to the ground. You say you're too simple to understand me, but what is there to understand here? My play failed to please you, despise my inspiration. You now think me worthless and commonplace like everybody else. How well I understand that. How well I understand, it's as if my life had been drained out. I had a nail driven into my brain. Damn it, and my pride sucks my blood, sucks it like a serpent. And here comes the true talent. And with this book too. Words. His sun hasn't yet reached you, but you're already smiling. Gaze has melted in his beams. I won't get in your way.
Takes snuff and vodka. She always wears black. Schoolmaster's in love with her.
Good afternoon, Boris Trigorin.
Good afternoon, Nina. I think I'm leaving today. Unexpectedly. It's a shame. It's not often I get to meet young girls. Young and interesting girls. Why, I can't simply imagine what it would be like to be 18 or 19. So in my stories and novels, the girls are usually false. Why, I would love to be in your place for simply an hour. Figure out how you think and see generally what kind of little thing you are.
And I would like to be in your place.
Why?
To learn how a famous and talented writer feels. What does being famous feel like?
Why?
How do you sense that you're famous?
Well, I've never really thought about it. I guess it's one of two things. Either you're over-exaggerating my fame, or it can't be felt at all.
And you read about yourself in the papers?
It's pleasant when it's praise, but when it's abuse, you feel out of sorts for a few days.
Oh, how I envy you. If you only knew. People's lots are very different. Some barely drag out their tedious, unnoticed existences. Each of them like the others. All of them unhappy. And then others, like you for instance, are given a life that is interesting, bright, full of meaning. You're happy.
I'm happy. You're talking now about fame, happiness, some bright, interesting existence, but I'm sorry, Nina. I find all those good words just like jelly, which I never eat. But you're very young and very kind.
Your life is splendid.
What is so splendid about it? I'm held day and night by just one obsessive thought. I must write, I must write, I must... I've no sooner finished a story than I'm already driven by something to write another. Then another. After that, a third, then a fourth. I write with no breaks, as if I'm travelling with relays of post horses and I can't do otherwise. What I ask you, Nina, is here that is splendid or bright. I have no rest for myself. I feel as though I'm devouring my own life, that in order to make the pollen in which I give to someone out there, I'm robbing my best flowers of their pollen. Tear the flowers apart themselves and trample them at their roots. Am I not a madman? Do my friends and loved ones treat me as a healthy human being? Oh, what little thing are you writing? What little treat are you going to give us? It's always the same. It's just the same. All this attention, all these compliments and praises, it's lies. Tell you lies like a sick man. One day I'm afraid that they're gonna come up behind me, grab me, and carry me off to the lunatic asylum. But, excuse me,
don't inspiration and the actual process of creation give you some elevated happy moments?
Why, yes, of course. When I'm writing, it feels good. Reading proofs feels good. Can't stand once it's published and I see a mistake. Think that it never should have been written at all. Feels so terribly low in spirit. When I die, my friends will walk past my grave and say, there lies Trigorin. He was a good writer, but not as good as Turgenev.
I'm sorry, but I don't want to understand you.
You're simply spoiled by success.
What success?
I don't like myself. I don't appreciate myself as a writer. And worst of all, I don't even understand what I write. I see the lake, the sky, the trees. I love nature. It stirs a passion in me, an irresistible desire to write. But then, in the end, I feel that I can only write about nature. That everything else I'm false. False to the marrow of my bones.
You're overworked. You've neither time nor the will to recognize your own value. If I were a writer like you, I'd give up my whole life to the public. But I know that its happiness only lay in the rising to my level. And the crowd would carry me along in a chariot.
In a chariot? Who am I? Agamemnon or someone?
For the happiness of being a writer or an actress, I would bear family hostility, poverty, disappointment. I would live in an attic and eat only rye bread. I would suffer from the dissatisfaction with myself, from the consciousness of my imperfections. But in return, I would demand fame. Real, resounding fame.
Oh, my head is spinning. Boris Alexeyevich!
I'm being called. Probably to pack. But I don't want to leave. It's such blessedness. It's so beautiful.
Do you see that house and garden on the far shore?
Yes.
That was my dead mother's house. I grew up there. I spent my entire life by this lake, and I know every little island on it.
Fine place you have. What is this?
The seagull. Konstantin killed it.
It's a beautiful bird. Oh, I don't want to leave. Persuade Irina to let me stay.
What are you writing?
A plot flashed through my mind. It's a plot for a short story. A young girl has lived since childhood on the shores of a lake. A young girl like you, she loves the lake like a seagull. And she's happy and free like a seagull. But then a man comes along, sees her, and idly kills her. Just like this seagull.
Boris Alexeyevich, where are you?
Here. What is it?
We're staying.
It's a dream.
Tear this love of mine out of my heart. Rip it out by the roots.
How?
I'm getting married. To Medvedenko.
To the schoolmaster?
Yes.
I do not understand the need.
To wait for years on end. To wait forever for something that will never come. But when I get married, there won't be any time for love. Who cares? We'll wipe out all the past. And anyways, there'll be a change. Shall we have another?
Won't that be too much?
Here you are now. Don't look at me with that expression on your face. Women drink oftener than you imagine. You're supposed to do it in private, not as openly as I do. They do indeed. And it's almost always vodka or brandy. To your good health. You're a straightforward man, and I'm sorry to say goodbye.
But I don't want to leave.
Why don't you ask her to stay?
She won't stay. Her son is behaving extraordinarily tactlessly. First, he tries to shoot himself. And now I've heard that he's trying to challenge me to a duel. What for? He snorts, sulks, preaches new art forms. And what for? There's room for all, new and old. Just don't understand why we have to wrestle.
Well, jealousy. It's none of my business. My schoolmaster isn't very clever, but he's a good man, and he loves me very much. I'm sorry for him, but I'm sorry for his old mother. Well, remember me kindly. I'm very grateful that you've been kind to me. Send me your letters, inscribed, please. Just don't write to my dear friend. Just write to Marcia, parentage forgotten, purpose of existence in the world unknown. Bye.
Odd or even?
Even?
No. I only have one P in my hand. I asked my fortune. Should I become an actress or not? I wish someone would give me some advice.
One can't simply give advice about that.
We're saying goodbye. And probably won't see each other anymore. Please accept this little medallion for me as a memento. Had your initials engraved. And on this side, the title of your book, Days and Nights.
Charming present.
Remember me sometimes.
I will. I'll remember a week ago. We were by the lake and we talked and there was that seagull.
Yes. The seagull. I can't talk anymore, they're coming. But before you go, give me 2 minutes, I beg you.
Stay at home, old thing. If your room is, the more she'd be going back visiting. Who went out just now? Nina.
Yes?
Pardon. We're in the way. I think I've packed everything. I'm worn out.
Pages 121. Lines 11 and 12.
Do you want a fishing rod, Patsy?
Yes, I'll be needing them, but give the books away to someone.
Yes, sir.
Pages 121. Lines 11 and 12. What do those lines say? Irina, are there any of my books in the house?
In my brother's study. In the corner cupboard.
Pages 121.
Really, Petrusha, stay at home.
You're leaving, it will be hard for me at home without you.
Stay here.
Well, I mean, I would head into town, I suppose. I mean, mean, there's not nothing much happening in particular, but all the same. I must go. There'll be the laying of the foundation stone at the Zemstvo Council House and things like that. I wish to jump out of this mudfish existence for an hour or two. I feel like I've become quite stale. Like an old cigarette holder. I've asked for the horses to be bought at one, we'll leave at the same time.
Stay here. No, catch a cold. Keep an eye on my son. Look after him, advise him. She'll leave, and still I won't know why Konstantin tried to shoot himself. Shoot himself! I think the main reason was jealousy. The sooner I take Trigorin from here, the better.
How shall I tell you? There were other reasons. I mean, one can understand a young man, clever, but lives in the country, in the back of beyond. No money, no future, no occupation. Understandably, he is ashamed and frightened of his idleness. I am fond of him, and I think he is quite attached to me, but in the end, he feels like an extra in the house. A sponger, a useless dependent.
The trouble he brings me. Should he go into government service?
I think it would be better if you gave him a little money. I mean, look at him. First, he should dress like a human being. He's been wearing the same jacket for 3 years now. He goes about without an overcoat. A few wild oats wouldn't come amiss. Let him go abroad or something. It's not expensive.
I can probably go as far as the suit. But abroad? No. At present, I can't even manage a suit. I have no money. No money!
No, my dear, don't get cross. I believe you. You are a fine and noble woman.
I have no money.
If I had money, believe me, I would give him some myself, but I have nothing. Not a 5 kopeck piece. My estate manager takes all my pension and spends it on farming, on cattle, beekeeping. But my money vanishes to no avail. The cows die, the bees die. I can never have horses.
Yes, I do have money. But I am an actress. My clothes alone have quite ruined me.
So, my dear, you are kind. Don't get too... Oh, but sorry, something the matter with me. Oh. I feel quite ill.
Oh, Patricia!
Oh, my head is spinning and...
Patricia, my darling! Oh, oh, help me! Help!
No, it's...
He feels ill.
No, it's... It's nothing. It's over now and... So on and so on.
Don't get frightened, Mama. Uncle often has this, you know. You should lie down.
Yes, I'll lie down, but I'll still go to town. I'll lie down for a bit, but I'll still go.
Yes, a riddle. Four legs in the morning, two at midday, and three in the evening.
Quite. And at night, flat on its back. Thank you. I can walk myself.
Oh, don't be polite.
I'm not being polite,
young man.
He frightened me.
It's not healthy for him to live in the country. Mama, if you could show some sudden generosity and lend him 1,500 or 2,000 rubles, he could live all year in town.
I have no money. I am an actress, not a banker.
Very well. Mama, fix my bandage. You do it so well.
And the doctor's late.
Well, they said he'd be here around 10, but it's already midday.
Sit down. It's like a turban on you. Yesterday, a call in the kitchen asked what nationality you were. But it's almost healed. There's next to nothing there. And when we've left, you won't go bang, bang again.
No, Mama, it was a moment of crazy despair and desperation. It won't happen again. You have magic hands. I remember long ago, when you still worked in the state theatres, a fight broke out in our courtyard. Do you remember they brought the laundress in, badly beaten up? You gave her medicines, washed her children in the tub. Do you remember?
No.
There were two ballet dancers who worked in the same building as us. We used to have coffee with them.
That I remember.
They were so religious. Recently, these past few days, Mama, I felt a love for you as strong and tender as in my childhood. I have no one left now but you. Only why do you give in to the influence of that man?
You don't understand him, Konstantin. He's a most noble person.
Yet his nobility didn't prevent him playing the coward. When he heard I was preparing to challenge him to a duel, he's decided to leave. The most shameful flight.
What nonsense. I myself asked him to leave here.
Most noble person, and yet here we are virtually quarrelling over him. Probably somewhere in the garden or the drawing room laughing at us. He's working on Nina's development, trying to convince her once and for all that he is a genius.
You find pleasure in saying nasty things to me. I admire that man, and I beg you not to speak badly of him in front of me.
Well, I don't admire him. I'm sorry, you want me to think he's a genius, but I can't lie. His books make me sick.
That's jealousy. People with aspirations but no talent have nothing left but to criticize those with genuine talent. What a consolation for them.
Genuine talent? If it comes to that, I'm more talented than all of you. I'm more talented than you and him. That you slaves of convention have stolen the prime places in the arts and everyone else you crush and stifle. I do not recognize any of you. I do not recognize you or him.
Young decadents!
Go back to your darling little theater and act in your pathetic, talentless play.
I have never appeared in plays like that. Leave me alone. You're not capable of writing even a wretched little vaudeville sketch. Qui est bourgeois?
Skin
parasite! A dirty tramp! Worthless creature! Don't cry. You mustn't cry. My darling child, forgive me. Forgive your wicked mother. Forgive me. I'm unhappy too.
If only you knew.
She doesn't love me. Can't write anymore. My hopes and dreams are gone.
Don't despair. Everything will be all right. He'll go away now. She will love you again. No. Stop it. We've now made up.
Very well, Mama.
Make your peace with him, too. You mustn't have a duel, must you?
Yes, only don't let me see him. It's more than I can bear. Oh, here he is now. I'll go out and the doctor will do the bandage later.
Page 121, lines 11 and 12. Here it is. If you ever need my life, come and take it.
There, bring the horses soon.
If you ever need my life, come and take it.
I hope all your things are packed now.
Yes! Why do I hear such sadness in this appeal from a pure spirit? If you ever need my life, come and take it. Let's stay one more day. Let's stay!
My dear, I know what's holding you here. But control yourself. You've gotten a little tipsy. Sober up!
You too must be sober. Be intelligent and show good sense. I beg you, Irina, take a look at this, all of this, as a good friend. Just be my friend. Just release me.
Are you so infatuated?
I'm called to her. Perhaps she's just what I need.
The love of a provincial girl. Oh, how little you know yourself.
Sometimes people sleep on their feet. It's as if when I'm talking to you, I'm asleep. Seeing her in a dream. I'm overcome by sweet, wondrous dreams. Just let me go.
No. No. I'm an ordinary woman. You mustn't talk to me like that. Don't torment me, Boris. I'm afraid.
You want to rise above the ordinary? Young, beautiful, poetic love. That's the one thing that can truly bring happiness. What? I've never felt such love. When I was young, I had no time. I was hanging round the doors of publishers, struggling with poverty. And at last, finally, this love has come. At last, it summons me. What sense is there to run away from it?
You're out of your mind.
Well?
Today you all conspired to torment me.
Oh, she doesn't understand. She doesn't want to understand.
Am I really now so old and ugly? You could talk to me of other women with no shame. You have gone mad. My beautiful, wonderful man. The last page of my life. If you leave me, even for a single hour, I won't survive. I shall go out of my mind. My marvelous, magnificent man. My conqueror.
Oh, someone might come in.
Let them. For I am not ashamed of my love for you. My treasure. My wild man. You want to behave like a lunatic. But I don't want you to. I won't let you. You are mine. You are mine. This forehead is mine. These eyes mine. It's beautiful. Silky hair is mine too. You're all mine. so talented. So wise. The best of all the writers today. You are Russia's one hope. You have such reserves of sincerity, simplicity, freshness, sane humor. In a single line, you can convey the essence of a person or a landscape. Your characters are alive. No one can read you without going into ecstasy. Do you think this praise is absurd? Am I a flatterer? Come, look into my eyes. Look here. Do I look like a liar? You see, only I can appreciate you. Only I tell you the truth. My dearest, wonderful friend, will you come? You will, you won't abandon me.
I have no will of my own. I've never had a will of my own. Feeble, flabby, always giving in. How can that appeal to a woman? Just take me, carry me off, but don't let me get a step away from you.
Now he's mine. But if you want to, you can stay. I myself will go off. And you come on later, in a week's time. In fact, what's the hurry?
No. Let's leave together.
As you like. Together it is. What are you doing?
Making a note. I heard a phrase this morning. The virgin's wood. It'll come in handy. So, ready to go back to railway stations, carriages, buffets, chops, conversations with strangers.
I have the melancholy honor of announcing that the horses are ready. My dear lady, when you leave, please remember to make one small inquiry for me. Where is Sylvester, the performer, now? Is he alive? Is he well? Once upon a time, we used to drink together, so please ask for me.
Here are some apples for your journey. Oh, feel like a treat.
You are very kind, Paulina.
I hope you enjoyed your stay. If anything wasn't quite right, oh, please forgive me.
Everything was all right. Oh. Everything was all right.
But our time is passing.
What can we do?
Sister, it is time. We mustn't be late after all that. I'm going to wait in the carriage.
I'll walk to the station to see you. I'll walk fast.
No, I don't.
Goodbye, my dears. For alive and well, we'll meet again next summer. Don't forget me. Here's a ruble. For the three of you.
I'll come with thanks, my lady. Have a good journey.
God bless.
Where's Konstantin? Tell him I'm leaving. We must say goodbye. Well, think of me kindly. I gave a ruble to the cook. That's for the three of you.
Oh, I think I left my book in here. You here, Boris Trigorin, have taken the irrevocable decision. The die is cast. I'm going on the stage. Tomorrow I won't be here. I'm leaving my father, leaving everything. I'm beginning a new life. I'm going like you to Moscow. We'll see each other there.
stay at the Slovansky Bazaar. Get word to me at once you're there. The Rokolsky Building on Moklanova Avenue. Oh, I must leave. I'm in a hurry. One minute more. The happiness it brings me that we will soon see each other again. I bet to see that beautiful smile, that pure, angelic expression. Oh, my darling.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to tell you that it is now the intermission. So, you have 10 minutes, then make your way back in, but if you could all step outside, I'm sure we have a lot to sort out in here. but yes, I do hope you enjoy your 10 minutes. We'll be right back with you.
Theater.
stands there like a skeleton, bare and ugly. Its curtains banging in the wind. When I walked by it yesterday, I could have sworn I saw someone weeping there.
Well.
Marsha, let's go.
I'm staying.
Marsha, let's go. The baby must be getting hungry.
Nonsense. My triola will feed him.
Poor boy. It's the third night without his mother.
You've become a bore. At least you used to give us a bit of philosophy, but now it's just the baby, home, the baby. There's all we ever hear from you.
Marsha, let's go!
Go yourself.
Your father won't give me a horse.
He will. Ask him and he will.
I will ask. You'll be home tomorrow.
Yes, you're nagging me.
Soren's asked for his bed to be made in Costa's room.
Let me.
The old man's the same as a child.
So I'll go. Bye, Marsha. Goodbye, Mother.
Oh, that's enough. Off you go. God bless.
Goodbye, Konstantin.
No one would have thought your guest question that you'd make a real writer. And now, thank God, magazines have begun to send you money. You've become handsome, too. Dear good Kostya, be a little nicer to my Mashenka.
Let him be, Mama.
She's a dear. No, a woman doesn't need much, only the odd tender look. I know from my own experience.
There, you to go and make him angry.
I'm sorry for you, Mashenka.
You're very helpful.
You know, I see everything. I understand everything. It's all nonsense.
Hopeless love only exists in novels, but you mustn't carry on waiting. Waiting by the sea for the weather to change. This love is flowered in your heart. Out with it. They've promised to transfer my Medvedenko to another district. Once we move, I'll forget everything. I'll rip it out of my heart by the roots.
Kostya's playing. Poor boy is depressed.
The only thing, Mama, is not to have him in front of my eyes. If only my Medvedenko gets the transfer, believe me, I'll forget it all in a month. It's all rubbish.
I now have 6 people at home, and flour is 70 kopecks apart.
So you must just try and get along.
It's all very well for you to laugh. You're rolling in money.
Money? My dear friend, in 30 years of practice, tireless practice, when I didn't have day or night to myself, I've only managed to save 2,000 rubles. And that I spent abroad the other day. I bought nothing.
Haven't you gone?
What do you expect when I'm not given a horse?
Get out of my sight.
Well, what a lot of changes you've made. A study out of a drawing room.
It's easier for Constantine's working. He can go outside whenever he likes.
Where's my sister?
She's gone to the station to meet Trigorin, and she'll be back right away.
If you thought it necessary to call for my sister, I must be seriously ill. Although, here's a funny thing. I'm seriously ill. Yet I'm still given no medicine.
Well, what do you want? Valerian drops, bicarbonate of soda, quinine?
Ah. The philosophy lesson begins. What torture! Is this made up for me?
Yes, we made it up for you, sorry.
Thank you. Now I wish to give Kostya an idea for a story. It should be called The Man Who Wanted To. Le Homme
Quia vu. At one time, in my youth, I wanted to become a writer, and didn't. I wanted to speak well, and spoke abominably, and so on, and so on, what with this and that. I used to sum up and sum up till the sweat poured off of me. Speaking of. I wanted to marry, and I didn't. I wanted to live in the city, and here I am, ending my life in the country.
You wanted to become a full state councillor, and did.
I did not plan on that. That just happened.
To express dissatisfaction with one's life at the age of 62, you must agree, is small-minded.
What a grouch you are. You must understand. I want to live.
That's silliness. By the laws of nature, all forms of life must have an end.
You are well fed. Life is easy for you. And so your indifference speaks. But just wait. For one day, you too will be afraid of dying.
The fear of death is an animal fear. One must overcome it. Only those who believe in eternal life or you are fearful because of their sins are consciously afraid of death. But firstly, you are an unbeliever. And secondly, what are your sins? For 25 years, you worked for the Department of Justice. That's all.
28.
We're stopping Konstantin working.
It doesn't matter.
Can I ask you, Doctor, what foreign city was your favorite?
Genoa.
Why Genoa?
It has an exceptional street crowd. When you go out of your hotel in the evening, the whole street is jammed with people. You move aimlessly in the crowd, this way, that way, zigzagging about. You merge with the crowd, you become one with it spiritually, and you begin to believe in the possibility of a single universal spirit. Like the one Nina once acted in your play. By the way, where is Nina now? Where is she and what's she doing?
That, Doctor, is a long story.
Then make it a short one.
Well, she left home. Took up with Trigorin. Did you know that?
I did.
She had a child. The child died. He lost his love for her and went back to previous attachments, as one might have expected. He never truly left, but sort of made do in both places. Personal life, as far as I can tell, from then on went completely wrong.
And the stage?
Worse still. She made her debut in the summer theatre just outside Moscow. Then went off to the provinces. Sometime, wherever she went, I followed. She always went for the main roles, but her acting was coarse and tasteless, full of abrupt gestures and noisy rhetoric. There were moments in a death scene or an exclamation where she would show her talent, but they were only moments.
So she really has talent?
Well, it was hard to tell. She must have. I used to see it in her. And I would go to her, but she wouldn't accept me, and I understood her mood and didn't insist on our meeting. What more can I tell you? I used to get letters from her. They were warm, intelligent. She never complained, but I could tell she was deeply unhappy. She used to sign herself the Seagull. In Rasulka, the miller signs himself the Raven in the same way that she signed herself the Seagull. She's here now.
What do you mean here?
At an inn in town. She's been here for nearly 5 days. Marsha went to see her, but she won't take anyone. And Medvedenko did say he saw her in a town 2 versts from here.
Yes, I did see her. She was walking the opposite way to the town. I bowed and asked when she would visit us, and she said she would.
She won't come. Her father and stepmother don't want to know her. They set up guards all around town to make sure she doesn't come too close to home. How easy it is, Doctor, to be a philosopher in theory but not in real life.
She was a delightful girl.
What?
I said, she was a delightful girl. Even full state councillor Sorin was in love with her for a time.
You old goat.
I think the compensation.
Yes, I hear Mama.
We all become old and weary under the elements, but you, my darling, you are gorgeous, beautiful, and as radiant as ever.
You want me to bring me bad luck again? You're boring now.
Sorin. Good evening. I'm very sorry to see that you're still unwell. Marsha?
You recognize me.
Married?
Long ago.
Are you happy? Your mother says you've forgotten the past and stopped being angry.
Boris has brought the magazine. What's your new story?
Thank you. You're very kind.
Yes. I get asked a lot about you. There's a lot of interest in you in Moscow and Petersburg. People ask what you're like. Are you young or old? For some reason, people think you're not young. They ask, are you fair or dark? And since you write under a pseudonym, nobody knows your real name. You're a mystery. Like a man in the iron mask.
Are you here for a long stay?
No. I'll head back to Moscow soon. I'm in a rush to finish a story, and I think I've promised something for an anthology of some sort. Same old story. This weather, it's given me the cruelest welcome. If the wind dies down, I'll go to the lake. Down to that place where you put on that performance that time. Got an idea for a story in my mind, but I have to refresh the setting in my memory.
Ah, let's see if we can take a horse. It's to get home.
You know, we can't be taken out again.
But there are other horses.
Marsha! I'll walk, really.
Walk? In a weather like this? Come on, ladies and gentlemen.
It's only 6 versts. Didn't want to bother anyone but the baby. Goodbye.
By those feet, just have to ride like a general.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen. Soon we'll be called to supper.
When the long autumn evenings come on, we play cards here. Just look. The old games table in which my mother used to play with us when we were children. Won't you play a game with us before supper? It's a boring game, but if you get used to it, it's quite nice.
He reads his own story, but doesn't even cut a page out of mine.
What about you, Kostya?
I'm sorry, I don't want to. I'll go for a walk.
The stake is 10 kopecks. We add for me, Doctor.
At your command.
Let everyone put down their sticks. Okay, I'm starting. 22.
Yes.
3.
Yes.
Put down 3. 8. 81. 10.
Don't go so fast, please.
What a reception they gave me in Kharkov. Heavens, my head is still spinning.
50.
The students gave me an ovation. 3 baskets of flowers. 2 wreaths. And this.
Now that is something. Oh.
77.
I wore an amazing frock. Whatever else I know how to dress.
Costa's playing. Poor boy's depressed. Oh,
the papers are awfully rude to him.
Why pay any attention?
He's unlucky. He hasn't found his real voice. There's something strange, ill-defined, at times like a delirium. It's not one live character. 7, 19. Do you think I would have become a rat if I lived in a house like this, by a lake? I don't think I would have. I would have overcome the urge and simply gone fishing. Oh. Catch a ruff or perch. What bliss.
But I believe in Konstantin. There's something there. There really is. He thinks in images. His stories are vivid, brightly colored, and I feel them stronger.
It's just a pity he has no definitive objectives. He makes an impression, that is all. And an impression on its own won't get you far. I'm entirely glad your son's a writer.
Can you imagine? I still haven't read him. I just have no time.
26.
Oh, by the way, Boris, we still have that thing that belongs to you.
What thing?
That time Konstantin shot his gull and we had it stuffed. We still have it.
I don't remember. I really don't.
I'm so dark, I don't know why I feel so anxious.
66.
Shut the window! There's a draft.
88. Ladies and gentlemen, I've won. Oh, bravo, bravo,
bravo, bravo. This gentleman is always lucky. Everywhere. And now let's go and have something to eat. Our great man has had no dinner today. Go on playing after supper. Kostya, clean up your manuscripts. Let's go and eat.
Sorry.
Patricia, supper. I shall tell you all about my reception. Oh. In Kharkov.
Please don't.
Talk so much of new forms, but now I feel myself slowly slipping into a rut. The pale-faced tree proclaims. The night and the dark tresses framed. Proclaimed. This is poor stuff. Start with the description of the hero being woken by the noise of the rain and all else out. The description of the moonlit evening is long and forced. Trigorin has developed his technique. It's easy for him. He has the broken neck of a glistening bottle in the sluice gate. There's his moonlit evening. Yes, increasingly I conclude that it's not a matter of old or new forms, but of a man writing without thinking of any forms. Writing because it flows freely from his soul. Who's there? Can't see anyone. Who's there? I hear footsteps. Nina! Nina, my darling girl has come back. You mustn't cry.
Someone's here.
There's no one here.
Lock the doors and they'll come in.
No one will come in.
Arkadina is here, lock the doors.
Well, this one doesn't have a lock on it, but I'll put a chair in front.
tomorrow. No one will come in.
Look at you. It's warm and nice. This was a drawing room then. Have I changed a lot?
Yes. You're thinner. Your eyes are larger. Nina, it's strange somehow that I'm seeing you now. Why wouldn't you let me come to you? I know you've been here nearly a week.
I'm afraid you would hate me. Every night I dread that you are looking at me and don't recognize me. If you knew. Since I arrived here, I've been coming and walking here. By the lake. Many times I've been close to your house, but I couldn't bring myself to go in. We'll talk and talk. It's nice here. Warm. Comfortable. Do you hear? Wind. Turgenev has a passage. Lucky is he who on such a night has a roof of a home above him. Has a warm nest. If our theatre was still there, still standing. I cried for the first time in 2 years and I got relief. Things became clearer in my heart. You see, I'm no longer crying. So, you're a writer now. You're a writer and I'm an actress. Live happily, like a child. I'd wake in the morning and start to sing. I love. I dreamed of being famous, but now, off to Yellets, early tomorrow morning, third class. And in Yellets, merchants with a bit of education will make up to me for their compliments. Life is cruel.
Why Yellets? Nina, I cursed you. I hated you. I tore up your letters, but I knew every second that my soul is bound to you forever. It's beyond my power to stop loving you. Ever since my life has changed, and I began to be published, I feel as if my youth has suddenly been cut off and I've lived out 90 years on this earth. I followed you. I kissed the ground on which you walked. Everywhere I go, everywhere, I see that beautiful face, that tender smile which shone on me in the best years of my life.
Why is he talking like this? Why is he talking like this?
I have no one's affection to warm me. I feel as if I'm living in a cave underground, and everything I write is all desiccated, stale, and somber. Nina, stay, please, or let me go away. For God's sake, why?
My horse is at the gate. Don't see me off, I'll go by myself. Give me some water.
Where are you off to now?
Town. Is Arkadina here?
Yes. Thursday, Uncle fell ill. We telegraphed for her to come.
Why do you say you kissed the ground on which I walked? I ought to be killed. I'm so exhausted. I could only rest. Rest. I'm a seagull. No, that's not right. I'm an actress. And he's here. Yes. Well, does it matter? He didn't believe in the theatre. He went on mocking my dreams. And little by little, I stopped believing in them myself. I lost heart. And always, the strains of love and jealousy. Constant fear for my child. I became petty, worthless. I acted mindlessly. I didn't know how to stand on the stage. I didn't know what to do with my hands. I wasn't in control of my voice. You can't imagine what it's like. Feel you're acting terribly. I am the seagull. The seagull. Do you remember? Shot a seagull. Left it at my feet. For a short story. A man just came along, saw it, and killed it for having nothing to do. But that's not right. What was I talking about before? Yes. I was talking about the stage. Now I'm not. I'm a real actress now. I act with enjoyment, with ecstasy. I feel drunk when I'm on stage and I feel that I am beautiful. Ever since I got here, I've been walking around. I've walked everywhere. I walk and walk and think and think and feel how every day my spiritual powers grow. Posture. I know now, I understand. In what we do, whether we act on the stage or we write, the important thing isn't fame or glory or anything I used to dream about, but the ability to endure. To know how to bear your cross and have faith. If I have faith, my pain is less. And when I think of my vocation, I'm not afraid of life.
You've found your road. You know where your vocation lies, but I'm still caught up in the chaos and dreams and images without knowing why or for whom they're for. I have no faith. I don't know where my vocation lies.
I'm going now. Bye. When I become a great actress, come and watch me. Do you promise? It's late. I can hardly stand on my feet. I'm worn out. Hungry.
Stay, I'll give you supper.
No, 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 don't see me off. I'll go for myself. My horse is in here. So, she brought him with her. When you see Trigorin, don't tell him anything. I love him. him more than before. Plot for a short story. I love him passionately. I love him to desperation. It was good before. Kostya. Do you remember? Was it a clear, warm, joyful, pure life? Feelings. Feelings like fine, delicate flowers. Do you remember? Men, lions, eagles, and partridges. Antlered deer, geese, spiders, silent fish which live in the water. Animals and organisms invisible to the eye. In short, all life has come together after completing its sad cycle. Thousands of centuries, the earth has not borne a single living being, and this poor moon lights her lantern to no purpose. In the meadow, the cranes give their waking cry no more, and in May, the cockchafers are no longer heard in the lime groves.
Thank you. America.
Yes.
And I wanted to ask you, by the way, as I'm very interested in the question. Take Arkadina somewhere away from here. Konstantin has shot himself.